I love when it's hot.
Psych boy, it's December.
And it's a swell time to go gliding in the one horse sleigh.
What up, guys? It's your girl M with the vibes coming to you live, baby. Period. So today, I decided I'ma do a Q&A because my first video, the real ones know that I did a get to know me tag, but I never did the whole thing. I said it was a part one.
Time question: what is my favorite drink? Let me tell y'all about this. Let me put y'all on to Monica's favorite drink, because y'all need to put on strawberry lemonade mixed with Sprite. Bro, when I tell you that thing differently slaps, bro. Like, oh, the heavens are singing. Like, bro, I don't think I understand.
So instead of doing like another part two of a get to know me tag, I said, why not do a Q&A? So I went on some website on Google. Yeah. I went on some website on Google and I searched up some Q&A questions. And I'm going to do a couple. And yeah. So first question. After a breakup, would you rather be alone or be surrounded by friends? After a breakup, I'm going to say I'd rather be alone, but not for a long period of time. I'd rather be alone to get myself back to normal, find peace within myself. You know, just have some alone time and just take time to myself to be back, to get back at where I'm at. But I'd say like time alone is not like, I just need a couple times alone. More time alone than more times with friends. Because like, I feel like if I'm surrounded by friends, I'ma kill their mood because I'm taking my breakup really hard. So yeah, that's what I would do. Am I a morning person or a night owl? I'm neither. But I'd say I'm more of a night owl. I'm starting to become more of a night owl. Cause like, yeah, I'd be up late at night. Yeah, sleep is rare to me now. I'd be up due to 3 out of 3. They always got me up late at night at some time of night. I'm less of a morning person, but like, I feel like I'm forced to be a morning person because of my siblings. They love being, as soon as they wake up, they feel like the whole house has to wake up. Due to them feeling like the whole house has to wake up, you see, I be waking up, the latest I get to sleep on a good day is like till 11 or 12. But if I do wake up early because of them, I just take a nap after breakfast. So either way, I still be asleep. Next question. Do I have a best friend? If so, then who? I have a boy best friend. That's my only best friend. He's been my best friend for 4 years. All throughout high school, he's been my best friend. I'm gonna put a clip in of him. But I did a video with him, like 2 videos. If the real no. Yeah, no. He's been in my videos, but I'm still put a clip of him. I don't have a female best friend. I don't trust females to be my best friend, so I don't want a female best friend. I'm cool with the close female friends I got now. Do I have a tattoo? I don't have a tattoo, but I promise you, when I turn like probably 21, I plan on getting one. I'm gonna show y'all. I'm gonna put a picture in of the tattoo I want. I don't know where I want it though. I think I want it on my back, under my boob, or on my wrist. Or like right there. I don't know. Do I have a lot of acquaintances or just a few very close friends? I have more close friends than acquaintances. Because, like, they know the real. I don't really like speaking to people. So my close friends, I'm literally my only friends, basically. Like, I don't have acquaintances that well. I'll put some clips in of my close friends so y'all know who I'm talking about. The real. My friends. My babies. My loves. I just want to say a shout out right now. I'm about to get real sentimental. But this is a shout out to all my close friends. I really love y'all dearly because y'all are real ones. Y'all have stuck with me when... Oh, Jesus. Y'all really stayed by me when I was a dummy. When I was head over heels. When I was going through my little tough times. When I was going through my little delinquent moments. Y'all still stayed by a girl's side. And y'all motivated me. And all that. I love y'all dearly. Y'all are really the bestest. Like, the friendships I have with y'all that, like, I couldn't ask for any better. And y'all mean a lot to me. Yeah. Do I prefer that people shoot straight with me or temper their words? Basically, the question is asking if y'all don't understand what I'm saying. Do I rather people tell me something that they need to tell me straight up, or should they beat around the bush? I'm going to say this right now, and I'm going to say this for anybody in future reference. Do not, if you're going to tell me something, do not beat around the bush. We're not five. We're not little kids. Tell me straight up what you need to tell me. I don't care if it's bad, the good, the ugly, whatever. I don't care. I'm going to take it how I take it. Just tell me straight up. I hate when people beat around the bush. It irritates me because it's like it builds up so much. What's the word? Builds up so much anticipation. Like, oh my gosh. It's so much anticipation. I can't. Because it's like, what do you have to say, bro? Just say it. So it irritates me. So yeah, if you ever have to, like, tell me something, do not beat around the bush, because that will get me even more upset. Do I remember my dreams? Yo, let me tell y'all something. I only remember the dreams that continuously repeat and repeat and repeat and repeat. I've been having, yo, y'all not even gonna believe this, but this is the truth. I've been having the same dreams for about 2 years now. Like, it's the same meaning, but it happens in a different way. And it gets me tight because, like, it's happened already, but yet I'm still having the dream. It gets me tight. Cause like, why are you still telling me this? Like, I'm about to throw my whole brain away. Like, the dream literally consists of the person I was with at the time, right? Was going out with this other female, and they did it behind my back, and I end up finding out, and it's just the same meaning. Like, this, that same thing, me finding out behind, they're doing it behind my back and I'm finding out. Like, it's getting me tight, because why am I still having this? Why am I still having this dream? Like, it gets me tight. It grinds my gears. Have I ever suffered a fracture? 3 times. Nah, in middle school, I was literally the most clumsiest person ever. Nah. From like fifth grade all the way on to like ninth grade, every year I was in the hospital for something. But fifth grade, I fractured my wrist because me and my cousin, we was doing the bridge. You know how they be doing the bridge, the gymnastics. I was doing it under her, and she was doing it on top of me. And then she told me she was falling, but I didn't hear her. So I came down, and then she came down and fell right on my wrist. Oh my gosh. I was in pain. That hurt. Yo, bro. There was another time I fractured my right ankle twice. But the first time is because, you see, I was running down the stairs leaving school. This was in seventh grade. I was running down the stairs. No. sixth grade. I was running down the stairs, and it was dismissal time. So I ran down and I jumped down the stairs and I jumped and landed on my ankle wrong and it twisted and I ended up getting fractured. And then the last time was in seventh grade. I was playing volleyball. I jumped, hit the ball, because this is a gym. I jumped, hit the ball, and landed down wrong on my ankle, so I ended up spraining my ankle. I promise you, every single time my grandparents or my mom had to come pick me up, they'd be like, why are you always hurting yourself? You can't just sit and do nothing. Like, why are you always hurting yourself? Sit and read a book or something. Like, they used to get tongue tight because they always had to come and pick me up early for school because I was always injuring myself. Nah, yo. Oh my gosh. Have I forgiven myself for past personal failures? Yes and no. I don't like seeing that I'm in the wrong, but now that I'm like more maturing and growing, I be seeing where I'm in the wrong and I be like, okay, yeah, I did so-and-so wrong. I understand and I forgive myself and I apologize for doing what I did wrong, because like, to grow, you need to realize your wrongdoings and grow from it. So this is what I do. If I could give my younger self any advice, what would it be? I would say not to let everything get to me, because when I was younger, every single little thing someone said, I let it get to me. I let it bring me down. I let them do this. I let them do that. And I let so much people walk over me, and it damaged me OD. Like, I let so many friends and relationships, I let so many people in them, like, walk all over me and do what they want. But like, now it's like, you're not gonna play me like I'm Bubba the Fool. No. For real. I'm like, no. Pick one. Forgiveness or vengeance. Why? I say forgiveness because I believe in karma. What goes around comes right back around. So I say forgive. I always say forgive but never forget. That's one. Because, like, forgive it. I mean, this doesn't have nothing to do with the question, but I want to say it. I always say forgive, but never forget. Because I'll forgive you for what you did to me, but I'll never forget the dirt you did to me. Like, don't even try and play me like I'm going to forget that. Because I'm not, baby. And I say more forgiveness because I believe in karma. That what goes around comes right back around. So, karma will come to you, whether now or later on in the future. Your karma will end up coming right back to you, baby. Your karma will come back to you. What do I think about the most? Honestly, I always think about my future. My future is always on my mind, like what's happening next, what I can do to improve my future, and all of that. My future, always, always, always. What has been the hardest thing for me to face or learn? One thing is that not everybody has a heart as big as me, and not everyone, friendship and relationship wise, not everyone has the same mindset as me, and not everyone has their head screwed on right. Like, basically, like, if I like certain stuff in a relationship that I feel like isn't valid or like is something like you shouldn't do to the other person, I believe that the other person should believe that. But I've really realized that and learned that not everyone has the same mindset as me. And it's been hard to learn, I promise you. But there's to a certain extent that, like, you realize, like, or you let it rock that not everyone has the same mindset as you, because, like, certain stuff still isn't right. So, like, yeah.
Oh my gosh, XL.
What is good about how I am living my life right now? One thing that is good is the fact that I'm taking a long time to myself and going back to realizing and enjoying my own company, because I feel as though I need time to myself because I can't deal with certain stuff. Like certain friendships and certain relationships, I don't have the energy for no more. And I've realized, like, yeah, nope,
It's better. My own company is better than this.
What is the best compliment that I ever received? I think it was in summer, well, now and summer 18. Because in 2018, that year, that whole school year, 10th grade year, 2018, I was the worst person ever. That was not Monica. I don't know who it was, but it wasn't me. And I left certain stuff to better myself. And I was starting to better myself. And everyone started coming to me and was like, Monica, I see your growth. I love your growth. You're growing. It's so beautiful. It's this. You're really starting to love yourself. You're starting to be this. You're starting to be this new person. I love it. I love it. I love it. And the same thing now, like certain stuff that I've been doing to do for myself. Like people are commenting me and like, Monica, you're glowing differently. Well, not really glowing differently, but you look like you're becoming at peace and you look more happy and all of that. And I love getting those compliments because like certain times it's people who don't really know what I've been going through, but they realize like, yo, you leveling up, sis, and I love it. And it just makes me happy when people compliment me saying that. And yeah, it makes me happy because like, you notice, like, oh my gosh, you really notice, you notice. Like I be so happy. I'm gonna find one more question. Who is the first person I call when something exciting or something horrible happens? First people I call, 3 out of 3. But the first people I text is the three amigos. 3 out of 3 is, I put a clip of 3 out of 3. Three amigos, I put in another clip of 3 amigos.
Girl. Gang, wait, baby.
Ooh. She's gonna throw the hanger at us.
Ooh.
But, nah. 3 out of 3, I call, like, bro, tell me why. 3 amigos, I text because they never answer their phone. So I be texting them, like, bro, blah, 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 like, tell me why this, tell me why that. Tell me why. That was me the whole summer because, yo, when I tell you, my summer was crazy. My summer was crazy. So much stuff was happening. I was like, hold up, hold up, hold up, hold up. Wait, can I get a breather? But that's the end of the video. That is Vlogmas Day 2. Stay tuned for more. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Tell a friend to tell a friend. I love y'all. I love the support that I'm getting. And that is that. Carvel on the beat.